Good morning and welcome to chapel. Let's stand together and worship our Lord. Sing, great is your faithfulness.
Great is your faithfulness, O God. You wrestle with the sinner's heart. You lead us by still waters and to mercy. And nothing can keep us apart.
So remember.
So remember your people. Remember your children. Remember your promise, oh God.
Sing it now, your grace.
Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough for me.
Sing, great is your love.
Great is your love and justice, God. You use the weak to lead the strong. You lead us by the song of your salvation. And all your people sing along.
So remember.
So remember your people. Remember your children. Remember your promise, oh God.
Yes.
Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough for me.
Sing that again. Your grace is enough.
Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough for me.
So remember.
So remember your people. Remember your children. Remember your promise, oh God.
Your grace is enough.
Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough for me.
Your grace is enough.
Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough for me.
Let's give the Lord a hand this morning.
Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, thank you for this opportunity of worship. Thank you for the good semester you've provided. Thank you for the 4 years or its equivalent as we've studied and we've learned, and now we come to the point of graduation. Bless us in your class. We pray, Father, that you would use it mightily in your work. Thank you now for what you're going to do here and what you're going to do in the future. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Thank you for coming. We're so glad to see all of you here today. Some of you, I'm sure, are looking forward to this being a place you can frequent in the future. And the rest of you probably looking forward to frequenting other places in the future. But in any case, we're glad that you've chosen to worship with us as we honor our graduating seniors today. It's my pleasure to introduce our speaker of the morning. His name is Dr. Thomas A. Kinchin. I met him 20 years ago. Now, back then, I had some black hair, and he did too. And across the next intervening 20 years, both of us have turned gray, but it's been fun. He's our president. He's not only our president, he's also our friend. And we're going to hear him gladly today. But you help me celebrate with him his 20th year, because this is a time when we can look back and say, hey, God's great and God's at work at the Baptist College of Florida, and he's used Dr. Kinchin in a mighty way here. So keep that in mind, and let's celebrate. And he'll probably say one or two things about this in the future. One of the things he'll probably say is, don't meddle in my business, but that's all right. I don't get here often, but when I do, I can pay for it later.
You guys stand with us as we continue to think about God's grace.
As a graduating senior class, I think every senior in this room would agree that we can't help but see the grace of God that has gotten us all through our life, but also to this point at the Baptist College of Florida, where we can say that we are finally about to graduate. Paul, the Apostle Paul, also talks of the grace of God all throughout his epistles. And I want to focus on one today. In 1 Corinthians chapter 15, he speaks of this grace. He says in verse 9, "For I am the least of the apostles, and do not even deserve to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God." In verse 10, he says, though, but by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace to me was not without effect. No, I worked harder than all of them, yet not I, but the grace of God that was with me.
Saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed.
Hallelujah.
My chains are gone.
Will be forever.
praise.
You are not a God created by human hands. You are not a God dependent on any mortal man. You are not a God in need of anything we can give by your plan. That's just the way it is.
You are not a God created.
You are not a God created by human hands. You are not a God dependent on any mortal man. You are not a God in need of anything we can give by your plan. That's just the way. You are God alone from before time began. You are on your throne. You are God alone. And right now, in the good times and bad, you are on your throne. You are God.
The only God whose power none can contain.
You're the only God whose name and praise will never end. You're the only God who's worthy of everything we can give.
You are God, that's just the way it is.
You are God. You are God alone.
miles of peace I've come to know. Though my heart and flesh may fail, there's an anchor for my soul. I can say it is well. Jesus has overcome, and the grave is overwhelmed. The victory is won. He is risen from the dead, and I will rise when He calls my name. No more sorrow, no more pain. I will rise on eagle's wings before my God, fall on my knees and rise. I will rise. There's a day that's drawing near, when this darkness breaks to light and the shadows disappear, and my face shall be my eyes.
Jesus has overcome.
Jesus has overcome.